Hey, and welcome back to Cooking with Ro. This month is all about the comfort food. So for today, we're making French onion soup, a highly popular French dish with surprisingly ancient roots. And as always, hit like and subscribe if you'd like to see more home cooking videos. Without further ado, let's get started. French onion soup traditionally uses beef stock, although you could sub in vegetable stock to make it vegetarian. For a classic French onion soup, you'll need about 5 to 6 large yellow onions, peeled and thinly sliced. 3 to 5 cloves of garlic. White wine. This is used to help deglaze the pan. And to intensify the beef flavor, we use a bouillon. They come in a cube shape as well as a paste. Freshly cracked black pepper. Herbs. We'll be using bay leaves and thyme, preferably fresh. A simple cooking oil. Here, I use avocado oil. Sugar to help caramelize the onions. Butter, about 4 to 6 tablespoons. And this step is optional, but as a topping is traditionally used, a French bread with some Gruyère cheese on top. I didn't have any at hand, so I use mozzarella. First, we're going to cut our onions into strips. Yes, all of them. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any tips on how not to ball your eyes out when you're cutting onions. As I mentioned before, this soup is quite ancient. Its gastronomic roots are in the broths of ancient Rome, prepared for the first time over 8,000 years ago. The recipe served up in restaurants across Paris and in kitchens of lovers of French cuisine everywhere took shape in the 18th century. It was introduced to the United States by a New York restaurant in 1861, although it didn't really become popular until the 1960s due to a greater interest in French cuisine. Now, once we're done slicing our onions finely, place them into a large stock pot. Then, we're going to mince our garlic and set it aside for later. Set your pot onto the stove and add in your butter. We're going to set our stove to medium heat. Add in your cooking oil. Lastly, add in some sugar to help caramelize these onions. Give it a good stir and get ready for quite a wait. I'll show you what caramelizing onions look like in each 10-minute intervals. At around the 37 mark, we start to get browning at the bottom of the pan. This is where we're going to start using our white wine. Pour in some white wine, and the alcohol will help deglaze the bottom of the pan and help that brown color come into the onions. Note how the color has started to turn. After your first deglazing and the onions have turned brown, add in your garlic, accompanied with another splash of wine. After about another 10 to 15 minutes, your onions should start looking like this, at which point we're ready to begin the next steps. Now that our onions are fully browned and caramelized, we're going to add in our stock. Followed by the cracked black pepper, our bay leaves, and lastly, our fresh thyme. If you're looking to richen your beef stock, now is when you would add the bouillon, be it in a cube or paste form. We're going to mix this all together. Then we're going to set the pot to boil, and once it starts boiling, lower the temperature to a comfortable simmer. We're going to let this simmer for about 30 minutes. Now for that delectable bread on top, we're going to set our oven to 450 degrees Fahrenheit. That would be about 230 degrees Celsius. We're going to take our oil and massage it onto both sides of our bread. It's most traditional to use French bread naturally, but here I'm using a sourdough bread I picked up at the local market that has some rosemary in it. Now that you've coated your bread on both sides with oil, it's time to place them into the oven. Depending on the type of bread you have, it can toast anywhere between 5 to 10 minutes. Once you pull them out, we're going to place our cheese on top of one side of the bread. Then we're going to place it back into the oven and bake it until the cheese is melted and bubbly, but keep a close eye on it so the cheese doesn't burn. This should be about 5 minutes at most. And now it's time to serve your soup with a slice of your toasted cheesy bread on top. To me, nothing can beat the coziness of a French onion soup in the fall and winter months. This concludes today's video. If you enjoyed, please leave a like and a comment down below. Let me know what other cozy foods I should feature later this month. And if you'd like to see more behind-the-scenes specials for upcoming videos and my other artistic photo shoots, take a look at Alquatica on Instagram and Facebook. See you next time. Ciao.